we already cooperate with the Korean brother and sister for a long, long time. And not only that, you know, 1 year is a Korean in fun, 1 year is Chinese in fun, and everybody working so smoothly. I feel very pressured to cooperate with KAAQ.
As we know, Korean and also Chinese community are brothers and sisters in Flushing. It's been, we had a history of building up our community together. So I really appreciate that we are part of, and it's my privilege to be a part of the Lunar New Year Parade.
This year parade time day is Saturday, February 9th. The parade will start on, like Peter said, on 11 a.m. on time. All the team who register, please gather your team in between 10 to 10:30. If you have four or vehicle registered to parade, you must bring your vehicle before 9. This year is our brother Korean team, they go first, okay? And the parade road is beginning on from 109 Bixi and go southbound to 74 Avenue, make a right turn, and 74 to Main Street, make another right turn. Korean team should go all the way to 37th Avenue, make a right turn, and dismiss at the 37th and the Union Street. Chinese team will go to 39th Avenue, make a right turn, and dismiss in the 39th Union Street.
This year, we have more than 30 all kinds of vehicles. That's including the Chinese team, the flow for the Chinese team, and the Korean team. So, welcome to join us, and happy Lunar New Year.
For the second consecutive year, there will be a review stage at the intersection of Main Street and the Casino Boulevard, where elected officials and all the VIP guests will be able to view the whole parade and interact with the participants. And we encourage everyone to be a part of 2019 Lunar New Year Parade and be the volunteer. So you can, if you're interested, if you have time to volunteer, please meet us at the front of the library at 7:30 a.m. On February 9th.
The library is very honored to be part of the Lunar New Year Parade. Last year, it was our first year to participate. And I want to tell you, our staff were amazed by how many organizations participate and how many people watch on the street and how well it was organized. So again, this year, we will participate. We will have about 60 people march. And our president and CEO Dennis Walker and our bookmobile will be also marching.
After the parade, the same place near the hotel from the 1 to 4 p.m. We set up over the 14 traditional Chinese cultural booths and the wonderful, our 15 wonderful the performers. So welcome the community people joining us.
Well, this year, FNT and our project, Tangram is also proud to be the sponsor of the parade and also the fireworks. So it's the same as last year's and like the previous years. After the parade, we will have the fireworks celebration with the traditional firecrackers in front of the Queen's Crossing Paris Baguette Plaza.
We're going to have about 250 officers assigned that day to the parade. So it's a very large number of officers we'll have out there to make sure everyone's going to be safe. Everyone's going to have a great time, so please encourage people to come out. Starting at 9 in the morning, Union Street between Northern Boulevard and Roosevelt Avenue will be closed, and starting at 10:30 a.m., the parade route will be closed. And there will be no local delivery trucks in the area during that time as well. So again, you know, the more we can get that out, the better everything will flow that day. All buses will be rerouted. There will be information at the bus stops, where the temporary bus stops will be. Roads will be open as soon as we can possibly get them open. We anticipate about 1:30 or 2. We have sanitation, Department of Sanitation is lined up. So just as the parade is clearing the parade route, sanitation will come in, start cleaning up the streets, And we'll be opening the roads as soon as possible to get everything back to normal for the businesses and for traffic and for anyone else who wants to come down to the area that day. If you park your car on 39th Avenue and 138th Street in that garage, just remember you need to get your car out of that garage by 10:30. If you don't get it out by 10:30, you're not going to be able to get it out until the parade ends. And lastly, we'll have no parking signs posted on Saturday. Saturday night into Sunday, they'll be towing cars if they're along the parade route. The cars are being relocated. They're not being towed to a pound where you have to pay a fine. They're being relocated to spots that they have designated to move cars off the parade route. If your car gets towed, if you don't get a chance to move it in time, contact 311 and they'll be able to give you assistance as to the location of where the car was relocated to.
We recognize how well organized this is. I think government has a lot to learn in some respects because you've shown how cooperation works, how bipartisanship works, and I think that's very important.
And now we have a community that works together, believes in one mission, one purpose, and I'm glad that we can sit here together collectively for the betterment of not only downtown Flushing, but for all Asian Americans.
So I want to thank each one of you for donating your time and your expertise for make sure we have a successful Lunar New Year parade. And of course, hopefully this year, the year of the pig, will bring fortune, prosperity, and health, and cooperation for our community.
95年那个当时的 assembly 们叫做 Brian McLaughlin 就问我们，你们说这个town好像是你们华人的town，那你们有什么文化的活动吗？所以当时的华商会 FCBA 就决定要争取大家的意见，后来决定说是要做游行，一直到今天已经第23年了。第一届那个时候走得很短，是从那个 Northern Burb 一直走到植物园。对，就从缅街这一条走到底这样。那第一届大概差不多有800多个人吧。那个时候，保守的估计一下，光在两边的，因为宣传也不够，光在两边观看游行的人数吧，应该不会超过2000人。从98年之后，也是我第一届担任主席的时候，我们接受了韩国人，也就是说，我们为了要跟韩国人合作，在他们的要求之下。从庆祝中国新年改为庆祝农历新年，那也是展开了第一次的华纳省的大团结。10年前，我开始要求 Mr. Mats， 还有更多的其他的族裔来一起游行，来 join 我们。那其实你可以看到，中国人的有容乃大，从包容了韩国人到包容了其他族裔。今年整个花车加上所有的车辆大概在30辆左右，那参加连韩国人加起来的话，因为我们现在预估的大概在7000-8000，可到时候都会上万。至于说 sidewalk 观看的，通常都不会低于10万。10年前，你就等一个什么大不了的州参议员啊，或者是州主席长了。或者市的什么官员啊，卡明写了局长哦，还不是民意代表，整个队伍都要等好久。那个时候的游行是不成气候，今天是反过来，谁都知道到 Flushing 来参加游行必须准时，因为我们不等人。
这个游行其实也得到像当地警局的一些帮助，记不记得第一次当时怎么去跟这个警局去沟通？
因为跟警局沟通，我为什么今天要 CB7 也来游行啊？一定要从警察局申请要经过地区社区委员会去安排交通局、消防局还有环保局，因为有好多单位要合作嘛，所以差不多在8-9年前我都还要接受他们的询问。原来我好像每一年都要去被拷问一样，这些年我想去备考，人家不考我了，他们就自动合作了，需要打电话就给打电话，不需要就不需要。所以我在想，这 这个是他们已经把我们当成是一个非常重要的一环在弗拉省。今天
这两年有多少的青少年的义工来参与到其中，觉得对于这个中国的传统文化做到了多少的作用？
越来越多的年轻人，其实我们在参与开会的时候，他才会真正了解说，哎，作为一个亚裔，我应该何去何从，我如何跟我的族裔来合作，来展现我想要的东西。希望所有的亚裔，你在各个岗位上都要，我们都要全力的支援，也只有这样才能够使我们的文化落地生根。